Welcome to the online training for the Wisconsin Bumblebee Brigade, a statewide citizen-based monitoring project. This training is divided into multiple parts, all of which are available through this YouTube playlist. This video provides an introduction to photographing bumblebees and curating your photos. Any type of digital camera can be used for the Bumblebee Brigade. Volunteers use basic point-and-shoot cameras, more complex DSLR cameras, and even cell phone cameras. We recommend using a camera with a resolution of 8 megapixels or higher. These days, almost all cameras meet that. Every camera is different, so we can't give step-by-step instructions on how to use yours for bumblebee photography. What works best is experimenting with your camera. Try out different settings to see what works best for you. Many volunteers who are just getting started find that the macro setting paired with auto exposure and auto focus work well for them. Stay calm when photographing bumblebees. When bees are nectaring or collecting pollen, you can be quite close to them without disturbing them. If you do disturb a bee and it flies away, stay still for a few moments and in many cases, it will fly back. When photographing a bumblebee, try to get a series of photos that show clear views of the dorsal, which means back, side, and face. In the photo shown, we have the dorsal view, the side view, and the face view. These views are key to identification and increase the chances that the bee can be successfully identified. Bees don't always cooperate with this, so you must do your best. Sometimes we can make an identification without all three views. Another good tip is to take a spacer photo between bees. So if you take a dozen pictures of one bee and then decide to move on, take a picture of your hand, your shirt, the sky, or anything else that will be clearly distinguished as a non-bee photo. Then, when you are looking through and curating your photos, it will be easy to see what photos are all of the same bee and when photos of a new bee begin. If you lose track of a bee and aren't sure if you are photographing the same or a different bee, assume for photography purposes that it is different. It is crucial that when you submit an observation to the Bumblebee Brigade, all the photos are of the same individual bee. Seeing the head of one bee, the thorax of another, and the abdomen of a third makes verifying the identification of bees almost impossible. Photographing bees can be difficult, especially when many bees are present. But be patient and make sure you get plenty of practice. Over time, your skills will improve. Let's go over those key views to photograph one more time. When at all possible, try to photograph and submit views of the bumblebee's back or dorsal sides, the side of the bee, and the face or head of the bee. This is very helpful for identification. After photographing bumblebees, you will need to curate your photos in order to finalize them for submission. The first step in curation is to identify the bees seen in each image. Identification is covered in a previous training video. Once all your photographs are identified, select the best photos of each observation's head, dorsal, and side views. Remember, an observation is a species-sex combination, such as a female in patience or a queen bimaculatus. You will often have many photographs that are not useful for identification. For instance, in the two photos shown here, the bumblebee is only barely visible on the left-hand side, but the right photo shows a clear view of the bee. You would, of course, choose to use the right photo instead of the one on the left. Once you have selected the images to use, crop and center the images so that the bee takes up a large amount of the frame. We should not have to zoom in and search the photo in order to find the bee or get a close look at it. Please ensure that your file size is less than 1 megabyte before you submit your photos. You can use any photo editing software you want to crop and center your photos. Most computers come with a basic editing software that provides all the tools you need. In the photo shown here, the bee is well centered but is too small compared to all the background. If you have a photo like this, we ask you to crop it so that the bee is much larger. Here's the same photo after being cropped in a standard photo editing program. The bee is now clearly visible when viewing the photo. This would be a great photo to save and submit. When selecting which photo to submit, don't worry about how beautiful or appealing a photo is. Instead, stay focused on how much information each photo provides. Many beautiful bumblebee photos don't provide the views necessary to identify the bees. And many less traditionally appealing photos provide what we need to help identify the bee. For instance, here are two examples of photos that won't win any photography contests, but that provide useful identification information. In the photo on the left, the bee is blurry and out of focus, but we can still see that the vertex on the head is yellow, that there is a darker patch on the thorax, and that only T1 of the abdomen is yellow. That tells us that this is a Bombus impatiens, the common eastern bumblebee. In the photo on the right, the bee is in focus, but he is in the background and partially obscured by the flower. However, the shot gives us a great view of the face, which is clearly very yellow. Shots of the face are often hard to get, so this photo will definitely add to your identification information. Combined with a nice shot of the back, you would be able to determine that this is a male Bombus vagans, the half-black bumblebee. Don't be reluctant to submit photos that are not perfectly framed or completely in focus. If you can see key identification characteristics in them and they are the best you have, please submit them. This concludes the photography and curation portion of the training. If you are new to the project, please be sure to watch all the training videos.